year, an electric Hanukkah menorah is mounted near the Christmas tree in my apartment lobby, with the correct number of candles shining each night. For much of Jewish history, Hanukkah was a holiday celebrated primarily in the home, lighting candles, eating special oil-based foods, giving gifts to children, playing games, gambling even. Even in America, when Hanukkah went more public in the 20th century with pageants and plays, its focus remained the home. When adults worried that their children would feel deprived, rabbis such as Samuel Markowitz advised parents to make Hanukkah a significant holiday with gifts wrapped in fancy paper. But in 21st century America, Hanukkah has moved very much into the public sphere, not only in my lobby. We see Hanukkah menorahs everywhere, large and small, in offices, parks, and event spaces. According to the rabbis, we light the Hanukkah candle to celebrate the miracle of the oil, the vial of oil that lasted for 8 days. But lighting a menorah in the window of a private home or an apartment window with candles that burn for maybe an hour won't get much noticed. In a certain way, then, the public display of the Hanukkah menorah is a contemporary variation on the imperative to publicize the miracle of Hanukkah. But if we're honest with ourselves, we know that for American Jews, Hanukkah has much less to do with celebrating God's miracle and much more to do with asserting our own Jewish distinctiveness proudly and publicly for all to see. Adam Sandler understood the essence of the message of Hanukkah for American Jews very well. Think of his Hanukkah song. Put on your yarmulke, it's time for Hanukkah. So much funukkah to celebrate Hanukkah, Sandler sings. When you feel like the only kid in town without a Christmas tree, here's a list of people who are Jewish, just like you and me. Sandler wants to help Jews feel less deprived on Hanukkah, not by extolling the holiday's virtues, but by identifying prominent Jewish entertainers. He recognizes that the power of Hanukkah for American Jews has much less to do with the Maccabees or the oil, and much more to do with Jews asserting their Jewishness at this very Christian time of year. When we do this, we're also celebrating the power of Hanukkah to provide meaning for every era. A post-biblical holiday, Hanukkah does not derive from divine mandate like the three major festivals of Pesach, Shavuot, and Sukkot, or of Yom Kippur. The rabbis later prescribed the proper way to light the candles, but they didn't originate the holiday either. The Maccabees invented Hanukkah, and they did so to celebrate their own military victory and their rededication of the temple. Bold and daring, chutzpahdik, really, the Maccabees created a holiday that endured, not only because of the timeless messages of religious freedom and the rich folk customs, but also because of its origin in innovation. Hanukkah reminds us that Judaism derives its strength both from its age-old values and traditions and from its innovative spirit, which is always giving rise to new forms of expression. May it always be so. Happy Hanukkah.